Riders Radio Theater will return following this shameless plug for a new show from Mammoth Radio Pictures.
Get ready, get set, saddle up and ride with the newest legend of the Old West, Palindrome.
There are campfire legends that the plainsmen spin, of a man who was nothing like Paladin. Couldn't ride, couldn't shoot, but he won his fame, 'cause everything he said, said backwards, was the same. Palindrome, palindrome, what's in a name? Palindrome, palindrome, backwards the same.
Yes, palindrome. No one knew where he came from, and no one cared. A new breed of lawman. No gun, no whip, no fancy knife. Just a knack for speaking only in phrases which said backwards are identical. Listen to this heart-stopping scene.
What's your name, stranger?
Madam, I'm Adam.
I didn't notice your horse outside, Adam. How'd you get to town?
A Toyota.
We don't cotton to drifters here, stranger. Reach for the sky. No possible way you can get out of this one.
A man, a plan, a canal, Panama!
Boom! Oh, you got me with that stupid straw hat.
Aha!
My hero, please come to my room for lunch.
Sex at noon, taxes.
Well, how about a dance?
If I had a hi-fi...
Yes, you too can hear timeless drama like this every week on Palindrome, starring Bob Otto Bob as Palindrome and Meg Jem as Six. Remember Palindrome, he gets them coming and going.
Check local listings for time and temperature. And now back to Riders Radio Theater. Riders Radio Theater will bounce back like a Romanian gymnast after this word.
Coming this summer to a theater near you, the blockbuster movie of all time.
There are campfire legends that the plainsmen spin, of a man who was nothing like Paladin. Couldn't ride, couldn't shoot, but he won his fame, 'cause everything he said, said backwards,
backwards
was the same. Palindrome, palindrome, what's in a name? Palindrome, palindrome, backwards the same.
Yes, Palindrome, the hit TV series on CBC, is now a movie. Palindrome. No one knew where he came from, and nobody cared. No gun, no whip, no fancy knife. Just a knack for speaking only in phrases which said backwards are identical. Listen to these pulse-pounding scenes.
Howdy, stranger. The face is familiar, but I don't recall the name.
Madam, I'm Adam.
I'm Elba. Thirsty, Adam? The weather's turned awful warm.
Too hot to hoot.
Here you go.
Duck, 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 duck.
You sound kind of stuffed up. Are your sinuses bothering you?
Tons of snot.
Well, I hope you're not allergic to all these old cats.
Senile felines.
All right, all right. Where's the punk that come to clean up this town?
Oh, no! It's Big Gib! He runs this town! He's a murderer and a thief! Oh.
Big Gib?
That's my name, Palindrome. That's the last words you'll ever say.
Draw, oh coward!
Why, you?
Yo! Oi!
dog guns.
I know you had plans to move on, but isn't there anything I could do to persuade you to stay?
Able was I, ere I saw Elba.
Yes, Palindrome the movie, with Bob Autobob as Palindrome and introducing Lil DeLille as Sis. He gets them coming and going. Palindrome coming to a theater near you.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's time once again to introduce one of the most beloved members of Writers in the Sky's rotating guests, a man who keeps us all on our linguistic toes, Mr. Literal.
Welcome, Mr. Literal, to the radio show today. When you speak to Mr. Literal, you better mean just what you say.
Yes, I guess he's my favorite guest. Welcome, Mr. Literal, to the show where we always have us a real good time.
Thank you, too, Slim.
Yes.
I'm fascinated, as always, by the myriad peculiarity of your speech. Today, I'm particularly struck by the redundancy of we always have us.
Well, of course, it's a simple colloquialism.
Yes, a point well taken, too, Slim, but inconsistently applied. Perhaps in the interest of consistency, you should say, we welcome us, you, to Writers Radio Theater, where Too Slim will tell him us some jokes. Ranger Doug will yodel him us a song, and Woody Paul will fiddle him us a tune.
Well, okay, Mr. Literal, I get me your point. Looks like I'm going to have to run the gauntlet once again with you.
Really? Is that like a run in your stocking, Slim?
I beg your pardon?
I believe the word you're looking for is gantlet, a form of military punishment in which the offender runs between rows of men who club him as he runs by.
Oh.
The gauntlet, on the other hand, and it is, of course, always on one hand or the other, is a protective glove worn by knights in armor, thrown as a challenge to a duel. One doesn't run the gauntlet, one throws it, and conversely, one cannot throw the gauntlet unless one is superhumanly strong. It makes them very cross indeed. Remember, run the gauntlet, throw the gauntlet.
Well, I stand corrected.
I should say you do.
Once again, I'm floundering on the rocks of correct usage here.
I should say you are, my dear fellow. Floundering means flapping or thrashing around, while I believe you mean to say foundering, which means quite the opposite, to fill with water and sink. Floundering on the rocks would be possible but painful, although in your case it may well be an accurate description.
Mr. Literal, you got me totally turned around. Linguistically, I just can't get orientated with your constant correction.
Well, glad to help, too, Slim, calling me at any time. I'm sure in your heart of hearts, of course, just between you and I, that you didn't intend to use the inflated and unnecessary orientate when the simple and elegant orient would do, doubtless a slip of the tongue.
Doubtless, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Literal. Here he goes.
When you speak to Mr. Literal, you better mean just what you say.
Change your damn tide, saddle pal. Riders Radio Theater will come out of seat number one right after this message.
He's back. He's bad, and he's on CBC.
There are campfire legends that the plainsmen spin, of a man who was nothing like Paladin. Couldn't ride, couldn't shoot, but he won his fame, 'cause everything he said, said backwards,
backwards,
backwards was the same. Palindrome, palindrome, what's in a name? Palindrome, palindrome, backwards the same.
Yes, palindrome. No one knew where he came from, and nobody cared. Here's a scene from this week's episode.
Oh, palindrome! The town doctor's been shot!
Yo, oi!
You're dead is our only hope!
Pa's a sap.
Yeah, we know that, palindrome, but what about your mother?
Ma is as selfless as I am.
You'll see some patience then?
Hey, yeah.
Oh, palindrome, my student has inflamed gums. What should I do?
Draw pupil's lip upward.
Mr. Palindrome, these warts are driving me crazy. Should I put straw on them?
Straw? No. Too stupid a fad. I put soot on warts.
Hey, Palindrome, hey. Say there, Palindrome, is it all right to drink alcoholic beverages, Palindrome?
Yo, bottoms up, U.S. motto, boy.
Mr. Palindrome, your medical wisdom has saved the town.
Now, sir, a war is won.
Oh, and you're so humble, too.
Revered, now I live on. Oh, did I do no evil, I wonder, ever?
Yes, Palindrome. He gets them coming and going. This week on the CBC.
Welcome, Mr. Literal, to the radio show today. When you speak to Mr. Literal, you better mean just what you say.
Well, it's once again time for one of my very favorite guests on Writers Radio Theater, Mr. Literal. And before we begin, Mr. Literal, I want to tell you something privately.
Yes.
You know, I think Ms. Marm kind of likes you.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Come on now. You can't mean it.
I think so.
I've never thought of myself as attractive to women, especially one as lovely as she.
No, I mean it. She's crazy over your correct usage.
Really?
She swoons at someone who takes the English language seriously.
That's me.
Oh, she's standing by herself over there.
It is I.
Why don't you take a second to get to know her better? Go on, Mr. Literal. Go ahead, come on.
Good evening, Smarm.
Oh, why, hello, Mr. Literal. I've been hoping you'd notice me someday. It's just awesome to meet you at last, having heard you thrill millions of us who care about proper usage over the airwaves.
Well, that may be, but my dear Miss Marm, you've used the adjective awesome without an accompanying noun.
Oh, Mr. Literal, I just get weak in the knees when you talk like that. I get goosebumps and butterflies and, oh, I don't know, it's just, it's like, oh, you know what I mean.
I'm afraid I don't, Ms. Marm. Your use of our language is so vague as to be nebulous and thus incomprehensible.
Oh, I just love it. Look, Mr. Literal, you know what I'm getting at. You know where I'm coming from.
Even if I did, Ms. Marm, which I assuredly do not, I'd be obligated to point out to you that while not invariably incorrect, it is generally considered poor usage to end phrases and sentences with prepositions.
Ooh, you make me melt, Mr. Literal. Let me be blunt.
You may be anything you wish, my dear. I can't stop you.
What I'm trying to say is...
Yes?
Could you give me some time after the show?
Oh, I'll give you better than that. I'll give you the time right now. It's 8:39.
Well, I meant...
And 19 seconds.
Oh, Mr. Literal, you just don't have a clue, do you?
Well, if I knew what mystery I was asked to solve, Ms. Marm, I might as well be in possession of the clue that... Ms. Marm, wait! Oh, dear. I fear there's been another misunderstanding. I'll never understand what women want. I guess I'd better just stick to correct usage of our beloved native tongue.
Gosh, tough luck, Mr. Literal.
Luck is neither tough nor tender, too slim. And besides, luck had nothing to do with this. It's simply a case of misdirected and misapplied usage.
Thanks to Mr. Literal on the radio show today. Let's hope for Mr. Literal someday he'll get a day.
Folks, the man who wrote 57 channels and nothing on obviously never tuned in Writers Radio Theater. We'll be right back after this provocative pronouncement from the CBC.
There are campfire legends that the plainsmen spin of a man who was nothing like Paladin. Couldn't ride, couldn't shoot, but he won his fame. 'Cause everything he said backwards.
Backwards
was the same. Palindrome, what's in a name?
Yeah.
again.
Palindrome, palindrome, backwards the same.
Yes, palindrome, no one knew where he came from and nobody cared. He won the West armed only with a knack for speaking in sentences, which spelled are the same backwards as forwards. This week's episode, Showdown at the OK Corral.
Hey, palindrome, when is the big showdown?
Noon.
Yeah, I heard you got family coming.
Pop.
Anybody else?
Mom's mom.
You're gonna need help, palindrome. Is Ed on your side?
Ed is on no side.
Look, over there at the OK Corral. That must be him.
Look, it's a two-headed gunfighter. A weird-looking dude. What's his name?
Neil, an alien.
Oh, palindrome, you're gonna need some nourishment. Here, I brought you some of my Chinese soup.
Wonton? Not now.
Hey, look. Palindrome's walking out towards the alien.
Yo, bozo boy.
I'm going to disintegrate you, palindrome.
Okay. K.O.
Look, Nico got him.
Now, sir, a war is won.
Didn't take long, either. What time is it?
12:21.
Gosh, palindrome, my hero, do you think they'll ever make your life into a movie?
Aye, madam, I made radio. So I dared. Am I mad? Am I?
Yes, palindrome, this week on the CBC, starring Bob Otto, Bob as palindrome, and Meg Jem as skit. Palindrome, he gets them coming and going.
Now back to Riders Radio Theater, where it's time for one of the most requested features on our show, Ask Mr. Literal.
Welcome, Mr. Literal, to the radio show today. When you speak to Mr. Literal, you better mean just what you say.
Well, it's once again, it's time for Mr. Literal. Thanks to a whelming popular demand, we have rebooked his... One of our most unusual guests. Yeah, I guess he's my personal favorite. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Literal. Thank you.
Thank you, Tristan.
Great to have you here, Mr. Literal.
And though I do not generally think of Riders Radio Theater as a political forum, let me say I'm just as pleased as punch to be part of a program bold enough to open the door to a voice for progressive political thought.
Wait a minute here,
as you know, I've long been the champion of the rights of the disadvantaged,
well, of course,
and of women, and of our black, brown, yellow, and red brothers and sisters.
Sir,
together, through compassionate and far-sighted political activism...
Wait a minute, hold on there. You don't look like Mr. Literal. You don't sound like Mr. Literal. You aren't nitpicking my word usage. You're using sloppy grammar. You're not Mr. Literal.
Why, no. Did you say Mr. Literal? Oh, there must be a terrible mistake.
Well, I booked the guests around here. Let me see that contract. You do have a contract, don't you?
Of course I have a contract. I've been a union man since 1944. I'm a member of the AFM, the CIO, the IWW, the AFL.
I knew it. You're not Mr. Literal. You're Mr. Liberal.
I certainly am. Actively espousing a progressive America for 45
but
years.
But we wanted Mr. Literal.
Oh, no. In that case, I've got to run. This could be a disaster.
Well, we don't mean to be rude. Please stay and enjoy our show.
I'd love to, but I've got to save a life. Our contracts obviously got switched. And at this moment, Mr. Literal is addressing the International Brotherhood of Sports Writers. They'll tear him limb from limb.
Well, so
that's
long,
all
Mr.
the time we have for Mr. Literal this week.
Thanks to Mr. Liberal on the radio show today. When we speak to Mr. Literal, we will ask if he's okay.
You say advertisement, I say advertisement. Whatever, neighbors, it's much too late to call the whole thing off. Here's a word about an upcoming show on CBC.
There are campfire legends that the plainsmen spin, of a man who was nothing like Paladin. Couldn't ride, couldn't shoot, but he won his fame. 'Cause everything he said, said backwards.
Backwards.
Backwards was the same. Palindrome, palindrome, what's in a name? Palindrome, palindrome, backwards the same.
Yes, palindrome. No one knew where he came from and nobody cared. He rode into town one day from out of the west, armed not with big six guns, a long rifle, a whip, some exotic knife, no, armed only with the neck for stringing together sentences which spelled forwards are exactly the same as spelled backwards. And now, a scene from this week's episode, Palindrome the Barber.
Hey, what's that you're putting on my hair, palindrome?
Lion oil.
Well, I don't think it'll help. This is the sorriest haircut I ever had.
Sue us.
I might do that, but what do you recommend until it grows out?
Tahiti hat.
Oh, great thinking. Well, here's a two-bit tip.
Wow.
Your next customer's that short guy over in the corner.
Flee to me, remote elf.
Hey there, palindrome. Just take a little off the top. Say, mind if I light up this stogie?
Cigar? Toss it in a can. It is so tragic.
Oh, all right. So, tell us about that big trip you made to the Danish amusement park, palindrome.
Tivoli, I love it.
How'd you find traveling with your parents?
Pa's a sap.
Yeah. And your mom?
Ma is as selfless as I am.
Say, what do you think of this new crowd in Washington, D.C., palindrome?
Tut, tut. Star comedy by Democrats. Tut, tut.
Hey, nobody said anything about how much weight I've lost.
Huh?
Yep, 50 pounds. You know, I'm a doctor, and I've proven that the best way to lose weight is simply don't eat. You ought to try it, palindrome.
Doc, note, I dissent. A fast never prevents a fatness. I diet on cod.
Yes, Palindrome, starring Bob Otto Bob as Palindrome and Meg Jem as Sis. Tune in next week and hear Palindrome name the best Japanese car.
A Toyota. Civic? A Toyota.
Palindrome, he gets them coming and going.
Where it's time for the popular Riders Radio Theater feature, The World of Words with Mr. Literal.
Welcome, Mr. Literal, to the radio show today. When you speak to Mr. Literal, you better mean just what you say.
Yo, Mr. Literal, welcome to the show.
Yo, too slim. Yo. Do you refer to one half of a child's toy which returns to the hand on a string?
No, that was a greeting, you know, yo.
I see. Or rather, I understand your latest massacre of our marvelous native tongue.
Well, what's today's topic, old literal meister?
I choose to ignore that, too slim. Today's topic is what I've christened the clarifying interrogative.
Sir?
Precisely. The clarifying interrogative is the word or phrase used when the listener fails to comprehend, whether willfully or not, the sense of what a fellow speaker has put forth.
Do what?
Exactly. Examples of the clarifying interrogative abound on this particular show.
Huh?
Yes, so much so that I sometimes feel rather poetically like a lost sailor on a sea of misusage.
Sorry?
Not as sorry as I am, Joey. And all of those, like me, who cry for our language.
Excuse me?
There are no excuses, Big Zeno, for the clarifying interrogative in most cases.
Say what?
I think I'm becoming ill.
Come again?
Not if I can help it. Let me out of here!
Thanks to Mr. Literal on the radio show today. When you speak
to Mr. Literal, you better mean just what you say.
That is Radio Theater. We'll be back following these well-chosen words.
Coming soon from the CBC Television Network.
There are campfire legends that the plainsmen spin, of a man who was nothing like Paladin. Couldn't ride, couldn't shoot, but he won his fame, 'cause everything he said backwards was the same. Palindrome, what's in a name? Palindrome, backwards the same.
Yes, palindrome. No one knew where he came from, and nobody cared. No six guns, no rifle, no huge knife, no weird whip. Just a stranger armed only with a knack for stringing together sentences that are spelled exactly the same backwards as forwards. Here's his, the famous barroom scene from this week's episode, Viva Los Palindrome.
Oh, Palindrome, back from Vegas already?
Yo, oi.
I hear it's a party in kind of town out there.
Party booby trap.
What? Say, you didn't.
Yay, no money.
Oh. Well, that's too bad. Tell you what, I'll buy you a drink. Set him up, barkeep. What do you have there, palindrome?
Lager, sir, is regal.
Say, palindrome, you want some fruit in it, like in that fancy uptown bar?
No lemons, no melon.
Okay. There you go. Say, I hear them roulette tables out there is fixed.
Never odd or even.
Sounds fishy to me, all right. But they say sooner or later in Las Vegas, every dog has his day.
Egad, an adage.
Kind of sarcastic, are we? Well, my sister Stella said she won big up there.
Gnu dung?
No, really. Packed a couple of billfolds full of cash.
Stella won no wallets.
You calling me a liar, palindrome?
Draw, oh coward!
Whoa, hold your hoises, boys. No need for that.
Huh?
Hey, palindrome, I guess this means your horse is for sale.
Bob?
Yeah, Bob. Good-looking horse. What would you take for him?
Must sell at tallest sum.
Well, it could go as high as $10.
Gnu dung.
Yes, palindrome. Join us next week when palindrome joins the circus and breaks into show business shoveling
gnu dung.
Yes, palindrome. He gets them coming and going.
And now, back by profound popular demand, that feature of Riders Radio Theater that blooms evergreen, Mr. Literal.
Welcome, Mr. Literal, to the radio show today. When you speak to Mr. Literal, you better mean just what you say.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, time once again to bring to you my favorite part of the show and my favorite guest, that living legend of linguistic legality, Mr. Literal. Mr. Literal joins us pre-recorded live before a live audience.
That was beautiful, too, Slim. Just beautiful.
Why, thank you.
Even a Russian judge would award a perfect 10 for that magnificent double pleonasm.
A double what?
Pleonasm, from the Greek. A needless repetition, a redundancy.
Well, to tell you the honest truth...
Beautiful. Another superb example.
Do you mean that I'm reiterating the totally obvious?
Exactly, Too Slim. You are learning from my little visits. For is there any real difference between a recording and a pre-recording? Is there any other kind of audience but a live audience? With the exception of that first show in Tahoe. To continue, the truth is, of course, honest. To iterate is already to repeat, and one can hardly be obvious without being totally obvious, can one now?
Well, I guess not, Mr. Literal. You sure are giving me a new and improved look at the bag and baggage of proper English usage.
New look, perhaps, but you still obviously do not see yet. After all, something cannot really be both new and improved at the same time, can it? And aren't bag and baggage exactly the same thing?
Wow, I never thought...
Obviously.
I never thought about it that way. Could you reiterate... Oops, sorry. Could you explain this so that even an old geezer like Side Meat could understand?
Slim, after all we've been through, think about it a moment. Just think. Can a geezer be anything but old?
Wait, now just a minute there, young fella. Who you calling old around here anyway? Why, you little...
You are a geezer, are you not?
Why, you little... Yeah, you chicken-chested, pointy-headed... But you can't even park your bicycle straight.
My, I thought too Slim's usage was deplorable.
Whoa, now hold on, you two. Pull your punches. Let's take a short intermission and reconvene at 2 p.m. in the afternoon.
Thank you, Mr. Literal, on the radio show today. When you speak to Mr. Literal, you better mean just what you say.
Now hold on to your hat, saddle pals. Riders Radio Theater will return.
He's coming!
The big screen event of a lifetime.
The action hero for a literate generation.
Palindrome!
Yes, palindrome. He's big. He's tough. He speaks only in phrases which, if spelled backwards, are exactly the same as when spelled forward.
Palindrome is out for blood in his motion picture hit,
I Maim Miami.
See Palindrome wreak havoc on an unstylish Cosa Nostra.
Bombard a drab mob.
See the terrible revenge of the poisonous martini.
Cat. Evil. Olive.
Thrill. The thrill to Palindrome sneaking into the Godfather's villa.
Step on no pets.
Witness the final showdown.
You're done for, Palindrome. We got Louisville sluggers, and all you got is that pitiful tenpenny fastener.
Stab nail at ill Italian bats.
Save me, Palindrome!
Flee to me, remote elf!
That's Palindrome in I Maim Miami.
Coming soon to a theater near you.
Palindrome, he gets 'em coming and going.